I hope you're not tired of people asking you about Peru, but I've got to ask, what does it feel like to have arguably the most successful song?
It's a blessing. To be honest, it's one of the things I always wanted to have, you know, a global record. I knew that it was going to be a smash because catchy lyrics, catchy hook. This is another Nigerian African smash, but I didn't see it like crossing all these borders and stuff. Nah, but this is like a dream come true for me.
How are you coping with all this success?
Well,
because it's a lot.
Yeah, it's a lot, but I mean, it's what anyone would pray for, to be honest. Like, it's just a blessing for me to be one of the few chosen to represent and to show the world how far African music has come.
When you were younger, did you ever envision this kind of success for yourself?
I knew I could sing, but I just thought it was just something I could do. You know, it wasn't until I got into uni when I was 16, 17, and I made my first song, and I was like, oh yeah, this is it.
And knowing what you know now and having achieved everything you've achieved, what advice would you give to your younger self?
Give yourself some time. I remember telling myself, oh, I want to be this young teenage sensation. As the universe would have it, I blew up quite later. And I'm just glad you need to hone stuff, to learn your craft. Sometimes it takes time, and for good reason.
And if you could choose any song that you've written or recorded that could get the same kind of recognition that Peru got, which song would it be and why?
Two songs come to mind. Mm-hmm. Vibration and Tattoo. I would really love for Tattoo to be this, you know, worldwide known R&B track.
So, you know when you go on Google and you search someone's name, so I searched your name, Fireboy, and then it comes up with these suggestions of things that other people have been searching about you. I've collated five of the top questions that people have asked on Google.
People
ask weird questions. Try and answer, but not thinking too much, because some of them are really random. But the first one is, what is Fireboy's top song of all time?
I love All My Babies, though, and I don't even have one.
But I'll let you choose top three, because I know it's a hard decision.
Thank you. I love All My Babies. Top three would be King, Tattoo, and I don't know, anyone can squeeze into the three, but those two are like top for me.
King is my favorite song, if you understand. Yeah. I'm happy with that.
I recorded that song at the lowest point of my life. As much as it's a song that's got a lot of braggadocio in it, and, you know, showing off and blah, 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 blah. Nah, I was broke, ugly. Just kidding. But like, basically, you get my point. I was like a typical dead guy. But like, and I just gone through, I think it was one babe that just made me feel somehow. And I just like, why? I don't deserve this. I'm too talented for this nonsense. And I just went to the studio and like made the song just to just make myself feel good. I was telling myself, are you making this song about self-esteem or are you just some narcissistic guy? I've never really gotten around to answering the question, but I'm glad that, you know, a lot of people connect to it.
To me, it sounds like a song of self-esteem. That's how I take it.
I mean, eventually, yeah. But I was just being honest with myself, don't mind me.
So the second one is, does Fireboy have a car?
Yes, I do. Why would anyone ask that on Google?
Maybe people want to be able to spot you driving on the street or something.
Nice one.
So the third one is, who is the richest between Fireboy and Rema?
How am I supposed to know? I want to know that. But Fireboy is very comfortable.
Where did Fireboy grow up?
I grew up in Abeokuta, Ogun State.
What's Fireboy's favorite meal?
At some point it used to be, don't laugh. It used to be pap and akara. I'm an old soul. I think that's the only explanation I can
give. That's like my grand's favorite meal.
Yeah, it's a granddad kind of meal.
That can be sweet.
And it just makes me relax and it makes me sleep. Yeah, them start to shake when they call
my name. Don't play with a ball like me. So you've got your new album, Playboy, coming out in August. What do you want fans to take away from the album?
I don't share much about my personal life, but what I want to always share with the fans is my growth as I proceed mentally. Oh, we're in the lover boy era. Oh, we're in the playboy era. Oh, someone has broken Fireboy's heart. I almost did not release Peru because of my overthinking self. So as soon as the song came out and I saw how successful it was, something just switched inside me like, yo, why don't you just relax and stop overthinking and just lean into the music? That's how this album came about. Playboy, just come out and play.
Where do you draw your inspiration from? How did growing up in Abeokuta influence your music?
I grew up not a lonely kid. I decided to be alone because I didn't have any friends. And I kind of like connected with myself and became very self-aware at a very young age. So I spent most of my time in solitude, discovering my gifts, discovering the things I'm good at. I was listening to a lot of Celine Dion, Elton John, the oldest people. And that's what shaped the soulful part of my Afrobeats. And of course, credit to Wandeko, because Wandeko brought soul into what we know as Afropop or Afrobeats today. So yeah, I learned that from him too.
You sing about being a bad boy from way back, but in real life, are you really a bad boy?
Well, first of all, say bad is subjective. But yeah, I mean, I do have fun outside the constraints of fame that is not known to the public eye.
What does that mean?
I enjoy myself. I do love to have fun.
And speaking of Peru, what was the inspiration behind that song?
A lot more songs. Maybe it's not my most profound song, but I mean, thinking about it, to be honest, I mean, there's a bit of some depth to it, but it's just a feel-good song. And well, I was in San Francisco, jamming. I just flew from Miami. Everything I said in that song was true, obviously, naturally. And I was supposed to go and rest, and we were supposed to record in the studio the next day. And then my manager was like, you know, let's just go and say hi to them and, you know, greet them. They're in the studio. Pay a courtesy visit, say hi. Everybody dips, come back tomorrow, refreshed, record. So I went there, I said, blah, blah, blah. And then she just started playing this beat. I was like, throw me in the booth. I was already feeling good. I'd, you know, I had a few stuff to drink. I was feeling good. And mentally, I was not really doing okay because at the time, I had not released any single that year. And the last thing they heard from me was Apollo in 2020. And everyone was asking, where's Fireboy? What's going on with Fireboy? He's not going to drop any song for us. That's where the warning one whammy came from. Warning one whammy means they said they've been looking for me. I'm in San Francisco, Jamie. So I basically said that out of pain. But the beauty of music is it comes out as pain, but when it gets out there, yeah. Everybody's vibing. But yeah, I just wanted to tell my story about how I found myself. That's my first time in the United States. And I was just enjoying myself. I went skydiving, got a neck tattoo, winked at strangers. I had a great time. I just wanted to just bring that energy into the song.
Into the song. How was skydiving, by the way? Because I'm planning
scary
to go.
Scary and beautiful at the same time. Yeah, the first two imagine. Seconds, the moment I jumped off the plane, I was filled with regret.
Yeah.
Why like, did why? You do this? What are you doing why? Here? You know what, I decided to just, the guy that was with me just spread my hands. Enjoy it! Enjoy the meal! What meal? We are 15,000.
Were your eyes closed the whole time?
At first, definitely, yeah.
Okay.
It's 14,000 feet away from the ground.
Yeah.
And you're telling me to open my eyes and enjoy the view. It's a beautiful feeling to feel scared and powerful at the same time. You will not get that feeling elsewhere. I would encourage you to do it at least once in your life.
Definitely, that's my plan. Next birthday.
But there's a 30-minute video explaining the dangers.
Huh. That's what they do.
And everything that could go wrong. So
and then they make you sign.
Don't say I didn't tell you. Yeah, and then you see, you sign stuff. So yeah.